A foam is created when gas is dispersed into a liquid, and if done correctly, it can result in a wonderful mouthfeel. Now, there are a bunch of different ways to make flavored foams, but today I'm going to focus on my two preferred methods that both involve the use of a whipping siphon like this, and my preferred brand is ISI, or ISI. You'll also need some of these nitrous oxide chargers for non-nefarious uses only, please. But once you understand the basic foam templates, you can have a lot of fun experimenting on your own. Now, to get your foam to hold, you'll need a stabilizer. I usually use gelatin or egg whites. Gelatin is a very efficient foaming agent and doesn't impart any odors to the foam, although it is a bit more of a complex process. On the other hand, egg whites have the benefit of being more readily available, and I tend to use them when citrus is involved in the foam because the acid will help stabilize the egg foam. All right, let's get to it. We're gonna make our first foam using gelatin and the wonderful Mr. Black coffee liqueur. And a big thank you to Mr. Black for sponsoring this video. More on them later. So here's a template you can follow when using gelatin to make your foams. And note, we're gonna be weighing out this liquid, and you'll see why in a second. Start with 3 ounces or 90 mils of your flavored liquid, in this case, our coffee liqueur. We're then gonna lengthen that a bit with 2 ounces or 60 mils of water. And this is optional, but I'm gonna hit this with about 6 dashes of chocolate bitters. Chocolate and coffee go amazing together. Next, we need to weigh out our gelatin sheet. I'm using silver gelatin that is 170 bloom strength. And we're shooting for 0.75% of the total weight of the liquid in gelatin. So in this case, that'd be about 1.1 grams. Then we're gonna add half of the liquid mixture to a saucepan along with the gelatin and dissolve the gelatin over low heat. And once that's fully dissolved, then pour in the remaining half of our liquid mixture. Now the liquid is added in 2 batches here so you don't damage all your flavor with heat. Now this is optional, but you can also weigh out 0.1% of the total liquid weight from the first step in xanthan gum, which will thicken the foam and create a more smooth and durable bubble structure. Here that'll be about 0.2 grams. Simply blend the xanthan gum into the gelatin mixture with an immersion blender like this, then chill the gelatin mixture in an ice bath to allow the gelatin to set. All right, and while we're chilling out here together, a reminder that gelatin is made from animal collagen, so vegetarians can use an equal amount of agar-agar powder. Just make sure to dissolve it in warm liquid. All right, once that's cool as a cucumber, we're gonna pour the whole thing into your whipping siphon, add 1 nitrous oxide charger, give it a little shake, then add another nitrous oxide charger, another little shake, and then store that in the fridge for at least 30 minutes to allow it to set. All right, we're about 3 minutes in, and we finally have our mise en place. So we're gonna make a Manhattan cocktail and top it with our coffee liqueur foam. Grab a mixing glass, and we're gonna start with 1 ounce or 30 mils of sweet vermouth. Next, we need 2 ounces or 60 mils of rye. I'm using a bonded rye here from Rittenhouse. Stir that with ice for about 45 seconds to chill and dilute it. I'm skipping the bitters here since we added those to the foam, but you could throw them in if you want. Strain that into a chilled coupe glass, preferably one a little bit larger in capacity to save room for that foam, which we are now going to gently layer on the top of the drink. It should look light and bubbly like this so that it incorporates into the drink as opposed to being too stiff of a foam that just sits on top of the drink, and let's give it a taste. And that right there, my friends, is a winner. It is light and airy with just the right amount of coffee and chocolate to complement the sweet vermouth and whiskey of the Manhattan. This is absolutely delicious in addition to being pretty fun to drink. All right, let's try another technique using egg whites as our thickening agent for our foam instead of gelatin. And again, I use this method when adding citrus to the foam because the acidity helps stiffen the egg foam. Moving on, we're gonna make a maple lemon foam for our inverted Sazerac. So start with 1.5 ounces or 45 mils of pure maple syrup into our whipping siphon. Then we're gonna add 1 ounce of fresh lemon juice. Make sure it has already been strained of the pulp. You don't want it to clog that whipper. And then we're gonna lengthen that with about 3 ounces or 90 mils of water. And again, this is a rough template you can use for any sweetener and citrus combination, but you might wanna go ahead and taste this at this point because if it's not balanced here, it's not gonna be balanced as a foam. Then take the egg whites of 2 large eggs and I like to beat them gently with a fork or whisk to get the process going. Pour that into the whipping siphon, and just like last time, we're going to add 1 nitrous oxide charger, give it a shake, add a 2nd nitrous oxide charger, and give it another shake, and store in the fridge for at least 30 minutes before using. All right, while that's setting, let's make our Sazerac base, starting with a generous 2.5 ounces or 75 mils of rye whiskey. grab some Peychaud's bitters, and I like to do about 3 healthy dashes into the mixing glass. Stir with ice for about 45 seconds to chill and dilute it. Spray some absinthe into a chilled rocks glass, maybe one for yourself. Then we're gonna strain in our Sazerac base, and it should have that nice bright red color from the Peychaud's bitters. Invert that whipping siphon, and we're gonna put a generous amount of that maple lemon foam right on top of the glass, fill it up, and then just add a bit of a lemon twist to get a bit more lemon essence on the top of the drink. Drop it in, and look at that beautiful drink, our inverted Sazerac. Is it any good? Come back into focus here, and yes, that is an excellent, excellent drink. While normally a spirit-forward cocktail, that maple lemon foam brightens up the drink in a really fun way. And what I love about this drink is that it evolves over time as the foam starts to seep into the base. All right, for our last drink, we're gonna learn how we can use a whipping siphon to simplify the greatest foam cocktail of all time, the Ramos Gin Fizz. And to do it, I'm gonna borrow a trick from the wonderful Cocktail Codex book. But first, a big thank you to Mr. Black for sponsoring this video. This is my go-to coffee liqueur for sipping or cocktails. And these guys know their coffee. They're not just distillers, but they're coffee roasters as well. And they make this amazing cold brew coffee liqueur that is 100% Arabica coffee beans. And all this flavor comes from the coffee itself. All natural, no artificial ingredients. But at the end of the day, only thing that matters is how it tastes. And it tastes incredible. I love to drink it straight over ice, which is why the bottles don't last very long in my liquor cabinet, but it's also amazing in cocktails. I also love it because it's not too sweet. You can always dial up the sweetness if you prefer, but it is more about the coffee than the sugar. That's why all my favorite bars and restaurants are using this for their coffee cocktails. Really, you guys just gotta try it. It's available all over the US, UK, Australia, and 10 other countries. You can go to MrBlack.co to find the nearest retailer. They just launched a YouTube channel. Go check that out. It's got some great recipes. I highly recommend it. And you can also get 10% off their online shop using the code COCKTAILCHEM10. I'll put a link in the description below. All right, back to our Ramos Gin Fizz. We're gonna build this directly in the whipping siphon, starting with 1 ounce or 30 mils of simple syrup. We're gonna balance that out with 1/4 ounce or about 7 mils of freshly strained lemon juice and the same amount of lime juice. Then 2 ounces or 60 mils of a dry gin. I'm using Plymouth here. The egg white of 1 large egg, 1 ounce or 30 mils of heavy cream, and then we're just gonna add 3 drops of orange flower water. And hey, you can see my camera tripod in a weirdly intense lighting all of a sudden. And this is your standard Ramos Gin Fizz recipe. We're gonna dry shake it in the whipping siphon for about 15 seconds, and then we're actually gonna add about 4 ice cubes directly into the whipping siphon, charge that with some NOS, and then we're gonna shake it for about 15 seconds to chill and dilute it. Then we're just gonna pour that out into a chilled glass. And I'm using a glass that's about half the capacity as you really should be using here. It is so light and airy, you should put this in the higher capacity pint glass. But when you're done, we're then going to just top it with some soda water after letting it sit for about a minute. Trying to get that foam head to rise above the glass, and a little bartender trick here is to pour the sparkling water down a bar spoon so it sinks right to the bottom of the glass. Now that is looking amazing, but you can see that there is so much foam here compared to the cocktail at the bottom. I put this in way too small a glass, so definitely saving some for later on that mustache. But that is an excellent drink and not something you have to pass around to 5 different bartenders to get right. Definitely give this one a shot. You can really do it with any egg white cocktail. It's awesome. Thanks for watching, y'all. If you want to see more advanced techniques like this, subscribe to the channel, and I'll put a couple fun ones up on screen as well. Cheers.